Speaking of theater, guess what song number four is?
That's it.
It's theater. Yes, it is. Let's go to the next.
Look, the young guy on the puppet.
I don't know if you have the introduction.
Yeah, let's go to the next slide. Theater was a song from Eurovision 1980. It came
second. Pantomimes, you know?
Yes. It came second place that year. So you were close. Almost won. And
Johnny Logan, my dear friend Johnny Logan.
Was he your dear friend then, or were you cursing him? Because if it was me, I would say, fuck Johnny Logan.
I
still say that.
I said this the second time, not the first time.
Alright, the first time he was still cool, and after yeah. that, you broke something over his head. Anyway, Katja Epstein. Is that how you say Katja Epstein? Yes, thank you, Jeremy. Let's play the clip before we talk about this song. There's one fact I want to point out. I don't remember if it's in this clip, but you played piano in this song, and you had gloves with small clowns painted on them. That's mad. Yeah. But it's great. I mean, no one would think who would think of that now? Someone sitting with a clothes of a clown.
I was just thinking because I played the intro, you know. I said I'm never a great piano player, I'm a good songwriter, but not a great piano player. But I said, so they see I'm not gonna play that well. So it takes care.
The clowns forgot
if I play wrong. They said it's a mistake of the clowns.
Okay, you know? That's a fact. Let's take a look at the video and see. Let's remind ourselves how good the song is. There they are. Who made these for you, Ralph? Did you make these yourself? Did you make those gloves yourself?
No.
No, somebody did.
I wanted to buy you.
Sie setzen jeden Abend eine Maske auf. Sie spielen wie die Rolle es verlangt. An das Theater haben sie ihr Herz verkauft. Sie stehen oben und die unten schauen sie an. Sie sind König Bettler Clown im offenen Licht.
Sang one line wrong, everybody was right, and I sang, and the clown was laughing.
The songwriter sings one line wrong.
Und das Publikum will nicht, dass eine Träne fließt. Und der Held, der muss stark sein und kämpfen für das Recht. Doch oft ist ihm von Bam der Baba da schlecht.
That must be funny in German, I'm not a German speaker.
This was really, really
German humor. Yeah.
Emotional, very emotional.
Okay.
No, the clown is a very important person, I think, in theater anyway. Mm. That's why I used Icy Kulp, very famous actor today. They're really, really, I mean, those pantomimes. But we worked hard, you know.
But I think it's another one.
I took a look at the lyrics translated into English, and from what I get out of it, the song is like about how clowns have to always be a certain way, and their own personal emotions have to be buried because they are there to entertain the audience. And did I get that right? That's when I looked at the
translation. Yes, you know how it looks inside, nobody cares, you know, yeah. You have to do your job behind the curtain, you have to do your
own business.
Welcome to the moment the curtain opens up, you have to do your job. Mm. You know? Mm. That's what we do. But the funny thing is that the English version is called It's Showtime and No Time. It was written by Fred Jacobson.
still no relation. Yeah.
Great, great, great lyricist. But he didn't write theater, it wouldn't have worked.
No.
You know, from Britain. Theatre. In French, we had a French version, yeah. Which did theatre, but English, it's showtime and no time.
Now there's many Eurovision songs that's in the national final, they start in one language, and then they get translated to English, and it's a totally different song. I think it's a little bit of a cheat sometimes.
That's, most of the time, it depends on the rhythm.
It depends on the rhythm, it depends on the beat.
Yeah. You know, I don't remember why, when we wrote Maybe, you know, we had Fourth there and Maybe, and we originally started out with another word. Every language has its own way of writing, mm-hmm. You know, and also its own way of pronouncing words, you know. So as I wrote this song, maybe for an Italian singer, for the most wonderful Valentina, you know, but it's different. Maybe if I would have written it from an American guy, I would have written maybe, I don't know, it's maybe, something totally different. It depends.
I think it would probably be someone saying, whatever. That's how American.
Whatever. Maybe.
Whatever. I'm sorry.
It's maybe for you, man.
Exactly. Are you still in touch with Katya? Do you still work with her?
I'm still in touch with Katya, and she's a wonderful, fantastic personality. She went into theater all the way. Mm-hmm. She performs Heine, she performs whatever Heine Lieder, she performs Tucholsky, she performs still theater, if I'm lucky, you know, but not, normally she's in the so-called big theater. She played a few roles, never got it to the big, let's say, cinema, because mm-hmm. some people always take her as half, say, so it's light music. You know,
is it difficult in Germany if you're an artist that does one thing to be able to
light, do light music and so-called chanson, cabaret, they beat each other a little bit. You know, we have a little bit problem in Germany, people accepting each other's work. You know, it's not what you do, it's just a question when you started. Whenever you started, you're in.
Okay.
You know, if you started with Schlager, they say Schlager, you know. Yeah. Schlager is the most stupid word in the world because Schlager in English means hit.
Don't say that to Swedes.
You know?
Don't say that to a Swedish person, because most people here are very much believe in
no,
Swedish Schlager.
No, very simple. Schlager means schlag. Beat, hit.
Yeah.
And
fun,
hit,
light,
hit was
easy.
The hit was a successful song. Mm. So, Schlager is not a successful song, you know?
No.
So it's a totally used wrong word after the war, and I always say skip this word Schlager, because Schlager is a successful. The rest is music. It's ballads, it's country music, it's whatever music, it's beautiful music, it's music you like or you don't like. But something which is not a big success and which people are not hum is not a Schlager.
Yeah.
But I try to change this and I will die and it will never be changed.
Ralph, this is another song. We've gone through three songs so far. This is another song that came second. You have songs in this list from second, third, fourth. I mean, you work all this time on a song, you get to the national final, and then you make it to Eurovision, and you don't win. Does that do something to you after a while? You've had 23 songs in Eurovision with one winner.
Three second, yeah, that's one time fourth points missing from Switzerland, mm-hmm. your neighbor, mm-hmm. no points. We were sitting there, I remember that, I said, okay, we need 4 points. One, no, thank God, two, thank God, no, three, no, four, we got it. We only need 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, France, and then you're second. And but thank God, because if we would have become second with this song, we would have never written a little piece.
Okay. Yeah,
that's destiny.
Yes.
That's destiny course, sometimes. Yeah. You know, we were number four with Genghis Khan, 79. We were number two with Theater in 80. We were with 9 points. We were number two with Johnny Blue, which will be probably the song you
and a little
play.
Piece was the
it's missing 4 points.
Yeah.
And if we would have won with Johnny Blue, I don't know if we would have ever gone with Nicole for the next year.
Yeah.
It probably wouldn't have happened. So life always gives good sides and bad sides. I mean, you have to be thankful to be in this business.
Yeah, exactly.
So second place, if we would be second this year, I would bow down and say, Daddy, let's be second.
But I think that's very gracious of you, actually.
Because I think I'm
not involved with Eurovision. I'm on the outside as a fan. But I don't know. If I think it is a competition. I mean, people are there to win, too.
And whoever wins deserves it, I think.
Okay.
That's the way it is.